Hi everyone, welcome to this episode of Ignition Time. Happy Thanksgiving to my beloved community. I want you to know that I appreciate you. I hope you have a healthy, happy and safe Thanksgiving, hopefully with some loved ones around you. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Dr. Nitin Chhoda with Ignition Time. If you don't know anything about me, check out my video. You'll learn more about who I am, what my journey has been like and why you should listen to me. Let's just jump right in into some important news from today. President-elect Joe Biden, in his first one-on-one interview post-election, was interviewed on NBC Nightly News by Lester Holt. And President-elect Biden spoke with Lester Holt about his cabinet picks, his transition of power, the plans to deal with the COVID situation, the plans to deal with the economy, and what were his priorities going into the new year, going into 2021. It was clear from this interview that President-elect Biden had certain priorities. Let's just jump into the important segments of this interview, and I'll show you, and you can see for yourself, what the priorities are for President-elect Biden. In the first segment that I'm about to share with you, Biden said, I quote, "We face a totally different world," and he said, "It has become America alone." I'll let you watch these segments, and I want to know what my viewers and subscribers think in the comment section below. You'll find a link to this segment also in the description section below, so you can watch the entire segment on your own. Let's roll the tape and see what President-elect Biden had to say to Lester Holt from NBC Nightly News, again, in the first interview post-election. So this is very important because this sets the tone for the next 4 years of for our country. And I want you to watch this first segment and let me know what you think. Let's roll the tape.
You announced some key members of your cabinet today, a very experienced group, a very diverse group. Clearly, you're trying to send a message. Can you articulate what that message is?
America's back. We're at the head of the table once again. I've spoken with over 20 world leaders, and they all are literally really pleased and somewhat excited. America is going to reassert its role in the world and be a coalition builder.
This lineup, those you've selected so far, a lot of familiar faces among them. What do you say to those who are wondering if you're trying to create a third Obama term?
This is not a third Obama term because we face a totally different world than we faced in the Obama-Biden administration. President Trump has changed the landscape. It's become America first, which meant America alone. We find ourselves in a position where our alliances are being frayed. It's a totally that's why I found people who join the administration and keep points that represent the spectrum of the American people as well as the spectrum of the Democratic Party.
Have you considered, for the sake of national unity, selecting or nominating a Republican, someone who voted for President Trump?
Yes, and we still have a lot more appointments to make. I want this country to be united. The purpose of our administration is, once again, united. We can't keep this virulent political dialogue going. It has to end.
Should we expect an announcement?
No.
Not ever or not soon?
No, not soon.
Okay.
Now, in the next segment, Biden was asked about potentially progressive picks in the cabinet, from the far left of his party. And he said something that I thought was very interesting. He said taking someone out of the Senate or the House would be a very difficult decision, but it would have to be made. In other words, imagine right now we have 50 Republican senators and 48 Democratic senators. If two Democrats win the Georgia Senate runoff races, it would be 50 and 50. But if one of those Democratic senators is picked to be in the Biden cabinet, then that seat now, essentially goes up for re-election, and that could affect the balance of power in the Senate. So this is extremely interesting that Biden would say something like that, because it indicates that the president-elect is potentially looking at some individuals, some Democrats in the Senate as well as the House to become a part of his cabinet. In fact, he even talked about Republicans being a part of his cabinet. So this is interesting. This seems encouraging. Let's watch this segment and you can judge for yourself. Let's roll the tape.
What about former rivals from your own party, Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren? Have you talked to them about cabinet positions?
Well, I've talked to them. Look, as I said, we already have significant representation among progressives in our administration, but there's nothing really off the table. But one thing is really critical. Taking someone out of the Senate, taking someone out of the House, particularly a person of consequence, is a really difficult decision that have to be made. I have a very ambitious, very progressive agenda, and it's going to take really strong leaders in the House and Senate to get it done.
The head of the GSA yesterday unlocked the mechanisms for there to be a formal transition of power, recognizing your status right now. Is that happening on the ground? Are there people talking right now who weren't talking yesterday?
Yes. Immediately, we've gotten outreach from the National Security Shop, from just across the board. and they're already working out my ability to get presidential daily briefs. We're already working out meeting with the COVID team in the White House and how to not only distribute but get from a vaccine being distributed to be a person able to get vaccinated. So I think we're going to not be so far behind the curve as we thought we might be in the past. And there's a lot of immediate discussion, and I must say the outreach has been sincere. There's not been begrudging so far, and I don't expect it to be. So yes, it's already begun.
Did you receive the presidential daily brief today?
Not today, but it will be starting very shortly, maybe as early as tomorrow.
Have you had any conversations with President Trump post-election about paving the way for this transition to happen? Any back-channel communications?
No, I believe that his chief of staff and my chief of staff have spoken. But no, I have not heard anything from President Trump.
In the third segment, President-elect Biden was asked about his priorities as far as reopening the economy was concerned. How should the vaccine be distributed? He did talk about the transition that is currently taking place from the current administration to the next administration. And he said we should focus on first responders. And he said that opening schools was a high priority for him. Let's roll the tape and see what Biden had to say about this.
You don't anticipate any harm from this delay in terms of your ability to do what you want starting day one?
No, look, it's a slow start, but it's starting. And there's 2 months left to go, so I'm feeling good about the ability to be able to get up to speed. And I fully expect, based on what we've heard so far, we'll get full cooperation from each of the agencies in question.
The day you take office, there could be two, maybe three vaccines out there.
Yes.
We understand that healthcare workers will be first in line. What about the rest of us? How will it roll out? Will we go to our doctor's office? Will we line up at a stadium to get them? Who will determine the order of recipients?
Well, look, first of all, I don't mean that in an accusatory way. Allegedly, the administration has set up a rollout how they think it should occur, what will be available, when, and how. And we'll look at that, and we may alter that. We may keep the exact same outline. But that's in train now. We haven't gotten that briefing yet. Secondly, I think talking to, as you may know, I've had a Zoom with the leading governors in the country, 5 Republicans, 5 Democrats. We've talked extensively about the need to cooperate and get the vaccine into places where you can actually get vaccinated, and their ideas of who they think should go first. I think we should be focusing on, obviously, the docs, the nurses, those people who are the first responders. I think we should also be focusing on being able to open schools as rapidly as we can. I think it can be done safely. So there's a lot to work out in the next 2 months as to exactly how it will be distributed. Now, maybe the hope is we can actually begin to distribute it. This administration can begin to distribute it before we are sworn in and take office. And so it's all in train right now. I'm feeling good, though, that now we'll be able to get all the hard data we need, which has been unavailable to us now.
And in the last segment, Biden talked about his priorities as far as dealing with the pandemic are concerned. He said we need to have a united voice on masks, social distancing, testing and tracing. And he did again reemphasize that he was very concerned about schools and the fact that, you know, what the Biden administration plan is for the future. Let's roll the tape and see what Biden had to say to Lester Holt on NBC Nightly News.
We know the vaccine is going to happen, but as we speak, people are ignoring advice to stay home. They're crowding airports around the country right now. You've called for a national mask mandate. How much power as president will you have to influence people in ways you have not been able to as a candidate?
I hope as president, and many of the Republican governors and mayors felt the same way, I hope that we're going to be able to have a united voice on the need to mask, socially distance, testing, and tracing. They're critical, critical pieces to dealing with bringing down this virus in a more manageable place. The words of a president matter, and I think it's critically important. I think it's a patriotic responsibility to wear a mask, to socially distance.
A moment ago, you mentioned schools. I want to ask you about that. New York City recently went back to at-home learning only. Some other big cities have made the same choice. What will you do to get kids back in school? How much will you be working the phones and working with governors
well,
and mayors?
It takes a lot of money to get them back. The estimates are $150 to $200 billion for the year it would take to get safely open our schools, for example. We know that we have to change everything from the ventilation systems in schools. We know we have to change the sanitary. We have to make sure everyone from sanitary workers right through to the bus drivers. They have to be clued in. They have to be protected, or they need the PPE. They need the gear. They need the ability to have smaller modules of classes.
You've got schools closed right now in places where restaurants are open. Are our priorities correct?
I think we should be able to do both. But look, I'm very concerned about the schools. And I, for example, I was on call yesterday was Mayor de Blasio, the largest school district in the country. He is in a position where it costs tens of millions of dollars to be able to safely open a school. So there's a lot we can do, but it is the single best expenditure of our dollars we can engage in now is to provide for these kinds of protection. Not only protective gear, but the PPP, meaning the ability to allow businesses and other operations to be able to open and have the wherewithal, the financial aid to open safely.
That's it, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something new from this video. My name is Dr. Nitin Chhoda with Ignition Time. This is some information about me. If you're new to our channel, I really appreciate you watching. If you learned something new, please consider gently igniting that like button, because the name of our channel is Ignition Time. Please, please click subscribe and enable notifications so you can become a part of our community going forward. We release videos at 2 p.m. East Coast time. That's 2 p.m. East Coast time on most days of the week. Get your cell phone out. Send a text message with the word Ignition or with the word Time 270,000, that's 70000, and you'll get added to SMS alerts list going forward. If you want, you can also get added to our email list. Simply go to ignitiontime.com/alerts. That's ignitiontime.com/alerts, and you'll get added to our email list going forward. So definitely become a part of our email list or our SMS list, and you can opt out of either the text messages or the emails at any point in time that you want. Now, sometimes YouTube does not always send out notifications on time. So there's a very simple solution. All you have to do is simply bookmark youtube.com/ignitiontime. That's youtube.com/ignitiontime. This way you'll be able to visit the homepage of our channel anytime you want and watch the videos anytime you want. So you're not dependent on YouTube notifications. Speaking of notifications, make sure to follow us on Instagram. Our Instagram handle is ignition_time. Become a part of our Instagram community, which is growing very, very rapidly, and you can get exclusive content from us on Instagram. You can also follow us on Twitter. Our Twitter handle is also ignition_time. You'll get real-time breaking news alerts on Twitter. You'll get them instantly as the news happens. So definitely follow us on Twitter and engage with us on Twitter. As always, if you learn something new from this video, please consider clicking the like button. Please subscribe. Please enable notifications. Please also share this video with friends and family, because that would be your vote of confidence in us and all the effort that goes into this channel behind the scenes. That tells the YouTube algorithm you found this content helpful. You'll always get the links to all of our resources in the description section below. We always do that. And finally, and most importantly, please comment below and engage with our community. I'm proud of our community because our community is growing, it's respectful, it's bipartisan, it's intelligent, and you can engage in a healthy debate with your fellow citizens. Thank you so much for watching. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next episode of Ignition Time. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.